It's time to talk about, President George Oppong-Weah. And it's looking like a reality now that, this guy, we talked about it yesterday. Mm-hmm. We talked about how the writing was on the wall, how his victory in the presidential runoff in Liberia was very imminent. Mm-hmm. And we got updates late last night that President George Weah is actually comfortably leading and barring any dramatic twist of events, we were the president of Liberia. I have to have that because it's politics, you know.
Yes.
Things can happen. You know.
You could see a lot of his supporters, a lot of his fans, they've traveled down this road before. I think 12 years ago or something. And so a lot of, for us here, we're like 65%. I mean, what rules, you know? But like you said, we've seen stranger things happen. So we're still waiting for the official confirmation. But a lot of people are ready for the victory party.
Yeah.
Congratulations from CAF, from all his friends, in the media, from everywhere. And I mean, you can understand why we're excited. I have fond memories of George Oppong-Weah.
Absolutely.
I can talk from now till tomorrow. I remember when Liberia came here, they were almost taking us out en route World Cup 2002.
Right.
And they were almost going to get
the
ticket.
They got so close.
So close.
Yeah.
It was hard for me to see the Liberian team as an opposition just because of George Oppong-Weah. And apart from that, he's an humanitarian. He's done a lot for African players. I mean, we've talked about how Steven Keshi too opened the door. This guy did a lot too in his playing days. I remember how he single-handedly carried the Liberian team, paid their bonuses, allowances, a lot of this he did. And for a man to have the stadiums packed full, you know, when he does his rallies, his campaign, without inducing the people, that's another thing that should be pointed out. And I'm really happy for him, although we await the official pronouncement. But
but
we know that in the next few days and weeks, when we say George Oppong-Weah, we will have to put president in front of that name.
Put a title to it. We're still waiting as we await the official confirmation. But according to Liberia's National Elections Commission, on Thursday, George Weah, out of the 98.1 ballot counted, George Weah has 61.5%. So writing is on the wall. It's looking very likely that President George Weah will be in charge of that country. We'll take over from Sir Elif Johnson very, very soon. And it's congratulations and from us here as we await that official confirmation. I mean, you talked about good memories and not so good memories. I think I want to classify Liberia almost preventing Nigeria from not qualifying for the World Cup as not so good memories, because it really, like, we were under pressure.
On the verge.
Serious, serious pressure, but we managed to scale through. Mm-hmm. So, but in all, if you look at George Weah's antecedents, you'd say there's hardly any negatives too, really.
Hardly. Mm. I'm looking for one. Well, maybe the guy he had booted. But all those things are
part of the game. Nothing major.
I mean, he's that good a person that we're really struggling to look for low points in his career as a footballer and how he's lived his life when this quest to become president of Liberia started. I mean, I'm struggling to look to get low. Look, ask anybody. Everybody has had good things to say about this man.
Right.
Although some will quickly throw in the fact, I mean, you said it yesterday, you know, you might be successful in one sector. Doesn't mean, it's not a guarantee that, you know, but let's bask in the euphoria that someone from this constituency,
absolutely,
a sportsman, goes all the way to get the highest office
in the land
anybody could dream of.
Wow.
It's worthy of emulation, and it's going to open the door for a lot of people.
Yeah, worthy of emulation, worthy of a lot of praise as well. So that's it for the presidential runoff in Liberia. George Weah looking very good for that position, for the first position in that country. Let's move on quickly. We're still talking football, but this time we're talking about the World Cup. And a few months ago, it was announced that the World Cup has been expanded from 32 teams to 48. And there were a lot of people that, you know, We're not too comfortable with that, but the FIFA president, Gianni Infantino, Yemi, reiterated over and over again that this is this is the way to go. And he is basing, all that on the fact that this expansion is very important and will aid development of football in those small countries, in quotes.
Yeah, nobody will argue with that. I think what people have argued, and I sympathize with those who are on that side, maybe the quality of the game is going to drop.
We can debate that.
Yeah,
it's debatable. Don't agree. Yeah,
let's hear Gianni Infantino. Let's see how convincing he sounds talking about the expansion of the World Cup and how it will benefit everybody. So let's listen to him. We'll come back for more Sports This Morning.
We have decided to increase the number of teams for the World Cup as of 2026 from 32 to 48. And we actually launched this discussion at the end of last year, including in this forum here in Dubai, with a plea by Samuel Eto'o, I can remember that, at the award ceremony, to increase the number of teams in order to give a chance to everyone to participate. So why did we increase the number of teams in the World Cup? Well, because there is no bigger boost for football development than the participation in a big competition. And we have to see what we can do there in order to make sure that we create a serious club football World Cup, in order to make sure that confederations and club football and leagues all over the world are developed at the same speed as it is happening in Europe. So we have some ideas and some plans about moving the Club World Cup to a different stage, to another stage, to a world stage, because FIFA, what its ambition and its task is to organize world-class competitions for the benefit of football all over the world. So I think that a new Club World Cup will also be set up in order to as well help development of football all around the world